As I mentioned earlier, ragas are more or less common across the three genres of khayal, drupad and instrumental music, but tala is not so. The very percussive instrument is different. Khayal and instrumental music, except for the rudrabeen, they use the tabla, while drupad uses the pakhavaj. But you know, there are some common features with regard to the idea of taal, and some very common aspects of the of taal in these two genres. So the basic idea, underlying concept of taal as time, as a time span divided into units, repeated cyclically, and the first matra or the sum being the pivot around which the presentation revolves, these are common to both drupad, khayal and also instrumental music. Now, other common features are that each tala is associated with a theka. A theka or a, which is a pattern of mnemonic syllables. And each tala is also associated with a set of codified hand gestures. So, every tala then is essentially associated with a theka or a set of strokes on the instrument with corresponding mnemonic syllables that name those strokes. Now, both tabla and pakhavaj have two playing surfaces. In the case of the tabla, they are mounted on two separate drums, whereas in the case of the pakhavaj, they are two sides of a horizontally held double-sided barrel. Now, in both tabla and pakhavaj, some strokes are played on one surface or the other, and some are a combination of strokes played on both. And each syllable of the theka of every taal corresponds to a particular stroke of the left or the right or a combination of the two. Or in other words, the theka is a pattern of specific strokes either on one or both surfaces. It will get clearer as we demonstrate. See, there is a vocabulary, a basic building blocks, and that, you know, these strokes are the basic vocabulary of the tabla. And some of these strokes in the case of tabla are tha, dhi, na, tu, etc.
Na, ta, tun, tit, ge, ke, dha, dhit.
Now let us look at a 12 matra tala called ek tal, whose bowl or whose theka is dhin, dhin, dha, ge, tir, kit, tu, na, kat, ta, dha, ge, tir, kit, dhi, na. This is the theka. Now, let us watch the demonstration of ek tal, and you can see that some strokes are played only on one surface of the tabla, on one of either the right or the left of the right or left drum of the tabla set. Some are played on both. The way I rendered the ektal theka, it was in madhyalaya, but you can have a vilambit ektal, It will be dhin, dhin, tha, ke, ti, ra, ki, ta, tu, and so on. And also, we can have drut ektal. It can be dhin dhin dhagitraka tu na katta dhagitraka dhina, dhin dhin dhagitraka tu na katta dhagitraka dhina. Let's watch the demonstration of these talas. There is a 12 matra tala in Dhrupad also, which is called Chartal or Chautal, which has a theka dha dha dhinta kitta dha dhinta kitta katta gati gana dha. Let's watch a demonstration of the Chartal. Again, you will see how the strokes on the right and the left side of the Pakhavaj combine to create this theka. In the last video, we heard the Tal Rupak of 7 matras. Let us listen to Rupak Tal performed. The theka is tin, tin, na, dhi, na, dhi, na. Each thala is associated with a theka. It is also called bol or a set of syllables that stand for these strokes. Further, the theka or the bol is arranged in guts. It is called gut or vibhaga. That is basically you have to take a teen thal. It has 16 matras, but it is arranged in 4 parts or 4 vibhagas or 4 matras. So when written, it will be like this. Dha, din, din, dha. That is the first vibhag. Then dha, din, din, dha. That is the second vibhag. Then dha, din, din, ta. That is the third one. And then you have ta, din, din, dha. That is the fourth vibhag. The vibhagas are all equal in the case of teen tal or even ek tal for that matter. So, it is called samabhibhag or samagut. These talas are called those which have equal vibhagas. Now, rupaka tal of seven matras that we saw is divided into three unequal parts of 3 plus 2 plus 2. Now, besides being associated with a teka, which is, you know, it's both the set of strokes on the tabla or pakhavaj and also the bowl or the syllables, the pattern of syllables that capture or name those strokes. So, besides be a teka, each tala is also associated with a codified way of being performed on the tala. On the hands, there's a pattern of gestures, hand gestures, which that is associated with each tal. And really, there are only two hand movements. One is tali, that is a beating of the palm downwards, and then you have a khali, which is an outward movement of the palm. And these hand gestures occur at the beginning of each of the vibhagas. So let us look at the take of tin tala. Can you have dha din din dha, dha din din dha, dha din din dha, dha din din dha. Now each vibhaga, the beginning, the first matra of each vibhaga is marked with a hand gesture, which is either tali or khali. That is, tali is this, khali is this. So, when we perform tin tal in through hand gestures, it will be dha, din, din, dha, dha, din, din, dha, dha, tin, tin, dha, dha, din, din, dha. Actually, historically, there is a distinction between sashabda kriya and nishabda kriya in the context of hand gestures that capture the tala. Sashabda kriya is with noise, with sound, and nishabda is without sound. So, kriya is of course action. So, the hand gestures that are involved in representing the tala can either be actions that make a sound, or they can be actions that don't make a sound. So, the tali is a sashabda kriya and the khali is nishabda kriya because it doesn't make a sound. So, in the case of teen tal, you have tali or beating the hand down with a sound on the first, fifth and 13th matras, and the khali or opening the palm outwards, which is a nishabda kriya, is on the 9th matra. And the matras in between, they are quietly counted with the fingers. So you have teen talas, dha, din, din, dha, dha, din, din, dha, dha, tin, tin, ta, ta, din, din, dha. And now, and this is an important point, while there are hand gestures to indicate the tal, hand gestures are rarely, if ever, performed during the performance of khayal or instrumental music. Now, in contrast, Carnatic music or even in Dhrupad for that matter, the tal is performed by hand. So, this is something I would like you to bear in mind, and we will talk more about this in the next video. Why it is this and what does it mean? Now, let us look at some other important talas that are used in khayal. We have already seen teen tal. We also saw ek tal, rupak. Now, we have another 16 matra tala called tilwada. It is also, as I said, has 16 matras and divided into 4 parts. But the bowl, the teka is different. So much so that there are some musicians who say that Tilwada and Teentaal are the same taal, only the theka is different. Tilwada is like this. Dha, tir, kit, dhin. Dhin, na, na, tin, tin. Ta, tir, kit, dhin. Dhin, na, na, dhin, dhin. And then we have another interesting taal called Jhumra of 14 matras. And the theka is like this. Dhin, dha, tir, kit, dhin, dhin, dha, ge, tir, kit, tin, ta, tir, kit, dhin, dhin, dha, ge, tir, kit, dhin. We also have a 10 matra cycle, 10 matra taal called Chaptaal. And the theka is like this. Dhi, na, dhi, dhi, na, ti, na, dhi, dhi, na. If I were to perform the hand gestures, dhi, na, dhi, dhi, na, ti, na, dhi, dhi, na. So, it can be an interesting exercise for you to just think about which of these talas has sama vibhag and which has vishama vibhag. That is, which are the talas that are divided into equal parts, that is, each part has an equal number of matras, and which are the talas of which the parts are unequal. They say Rupaka is a Vishamataal, that is, you have tin, tin, na, dhi, na, dhi, na. So you have 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1, 2. So it has three parts and they are unequal. So which are the talas in this are like Rupak, no? Vishama Vibhag. So to sum up then, just as we describe ragas in terms of certain parameters, taala also is described in terms of some parameters. First, of course, you have the number of matras per avartam. Then we mentioned the vibhagas, that is, the matras are divided into sections or parts, and these may be equal or unequal. The taali and khali are also important part of the description of the taala. So, when we have to describe Teentaal, it will go something like this. The Teentaal has 16 matras divided into 4 vibhagas or parts of 4 matras each, with a taali on the first, fifth and 13th matras and Khali on the 9th matra. And the Theka is an integral part of the description of the Tala. There are musicians and musicologists who equate Tala with the Theka. So, from all this, it emerges that in a Tala, not all matras are equal. The sum is by far the most important, followed by the matras that are marked in Talis and Khalis. That is important in what sense? In terms of how they figure in the presentation of the music, in the dynamics, the building of tension and release of the music, the construction of the composition, and so on. We will look in the next video at tabla as an accompaniment for khayal and instrumental music, and how it is different from say the Bakhavaj or the mridangam of Carnatic music.